Hey, Azure offers a large set of different services, like platform as a service and infrastructure as a service, where you can deploy and run your Windows Server virtual machine as well as your Linux virtual machines. And when you look at PaaS services are really managed by Azure in the background. Wouldn't it be great if we could leverage the Azure management tool and let Azure manage our virtual machines running on infrastructure as a service as well? That is where Azure Automanage comes in. So let's have a look. So if you're running virtual machines in Azure, doesn't matter if it's Linux or Windows, you will need to take care of the operating system and manage these virtual machines, right? So you're responsible for making sure that the operating system is up to date, that it's secured, that you have backup your virtual machine, and much, much more. And again, Azure is a great platform and offers you different tools as well as third-party tools to actually do that. And we even provide you with guidance of the cloud adoption framework on how the best practices are. Now, this still means you need to configure all of these services. Again, also when it comes to monitoring, backup, and all of that. And so many of our customers said, hey, wouldn't it be great if we just could like let Azure manage our virtual machines as well? And that is exactly what Azure Automanage does. So if we're looking here at the documentation, you can see here that we offer a whole set of services to manage your server virtual machines. It can be like with security center, monitoring, update management, automation, change tracking and inventory, configuration management, log analytics, and backup. Now, however, in general, as I said, you are responsible to onboard all these management services. Now with Azure Automanage, we are going to do that for you. So you can now onboard Linux and Windows servers to Azure Automanage, and we will configure the best practices for these management services using information from the cloud adoption framework. So let me show you how you can onboard a machine to Azure Automanage. For that, we're just going to the portal, and you can see here, if I go to virtual machines, I can see here I'm running already a couple of virtual machines here. And some of them are onboarded already to Azure Automanage. Some of them are managed by myself. If I want to onboard more machines or manage Azure Automanage, I simply go to Automanage in the portal, and you will see here that I already onboarded a machine here. I can now enable that on existing machines. So why not just select that, and then I can select the machine I want to onboard. Again, if I run a large set of virtual machines, I could actually filter here by name and different attributes. But in my case, I want to actually onboard this specific machine here. And you can see here, it also tells me if I actually can onboard that machine. So if the machine is not online, I, for example, can't really do that. So I need to start the machine here as well. I select the machine, and now I can choose between different configurations. Not necessarily all machines are running in production. So not every machine needs to be backed up or it gets like really like monitoring I need to have every alert directly in my inbox. So therefore, you can choose if this virtual machine belongs to a dev test environment or if it's actually a production workloads. And you can compare what actually these environments are and what the settings for these are. So if I'm running in production, you can see here I get machine insights, monitoring, backup, security center, anti-malware, update management, change tracking and inventory, guest configuration, Azure automation, and log analytics directly configured for that machine. If I switch to a dev test environment, you can see here that some of these options are going away because we don't really think that some of these VMs are necessary to have all these options available. Again, you can basically say what you want, even though if it's probably a test machine, dev test machine, you maybe want to treat it like a production machine. So you can choose whatever works best for you. So in my case, I will select that this is a production machine, and then I can configure the settings for these services. So we gave you a default set called the Azure Best Practices. Again, this is coming from the cloud adoption framework. But, and you can even here have a look at the details, what's actually included and how we did configure that. So for example, you can see here our daily backup schedule is set and how we configure like Microsoft anti-malware support. However, if you want to have that different, you can also create your own settings. So with that, you could give that a name. You can obviously need to store these settings in a resource group. And then you can configure different services like backup or the anti-malware service directly within that template. So if you want to have a different backup schedule, you can absolutely do that. Under advanced, you can also then say, okay, what is going to be the Azure managed identity? Where these operations are going to happen. And so you can create an account for this, or Azure will automatically create an account for you in that sense. So for that, I'm just gonna hit enable, and this will then onboard my machine to Azure Automanage and manage the machine for me. And while this is running, and this will take a while until all the management services are onboarded, let's have a look at the machine I already have configured with Azure Automanage. So in this case, you can see here, again, it's a normal Azure virtual machine as I know it and I would create it, but it's already onboarded to a couple of the management services. So for example, if I go to backup, you can see here, backup is configured for me and I already have a couple of backups in that sense. I can go to inventory, and I can see here all the software inventory I have on that machine. I can see the change tracking results. So if I have any changes to that specific machine, it's set up. And I can do a couple of other things as I just showed you, as well as, for example, the monitoring part where I get the dependency map to see to which endpoints or servers this server is connecting. And I obviously also get performance monitoring for that. So I can see the disk utilization and disk performance, as well as CPU utilization, memory utilization, and much, much more information as I need when I manage that virtual machine. So Azure Automanage is a great way of reducing the management overhead which come with infrastructure as a service. And it should make your life easier, and we apply basically our best practices to your Azure virtual machines. Again, you can onboard your Azure VMs, if they're Linux or Windows Server virtual machines, manually, or you can also leverage Azure policy to automatically onboard new virtual machines in Azure directly to Azure Automanage. I hope this video was helpful. Let me know if you liked it and subscribe to the channel.